afternoon, viewers are back again with Muti Amelia at a glance of the info spreading news of criminal crimes. A husband in Dumai City, Riau, had the heart to burn his wife, allegedly not waiting a divorce. The chronology: that morning, Victor Rahmi was preparing merchandise at his kiosk. Not so long after, a scam with the gasoline, then the perpetrator immediately poured it on the kiosk and set it on fire. According to local witness, the victim did not know the perpetrator arrived, so he was caught in the flames and did not have time to save himself. After launching his action, he tried to escape. However, this was prevented by the people who saw it. Residents quickly called the perpetrator. The effects of the mesh could not be avoided until the police came to secure some residents who still found the perpetrators. After the fire can be extinguished, the victim who has died is taken to the hospital for defibrillation. There's a nose also of husband and wife spread through a video recording on several social media. Netizen who saw the video criticized the husband's barbaric action. It is known from the Instagram account at information.terkini.ektisik. One of the accounts that upload this recording said this incident occurred at around 8:30 WIB on Thursday, 12 August 2020, at Simpang Kelakap 7, Dumai City, Riau. Currently, the case is still being processed, and the perpetrator is receiving treatment for burn caused by his own action. The next news comes from a young man in Deli Serdang, North Sumatra, with the initial ZN, who was molesting his younger sister A to death. The perpetrator hid the hurt to abuse his sister using a hose so that the victim suffered serious injuries to the head. The surfer's abuse took place at his home in Ex-Kamplimang Hamlet, Forkat St. John, Deli Serdang Regency, North Sumatra, Friday afternoon, June 4, 2001. Firstly, between GN and A had been involved in a further argument in the kitchen room of the house. The perpetrator was furious and then saw a hole and immediately took it. He immediately beat the victim repeatedly until they fell to the ground covered in blood. Knowing the bloody conflict between her two children, the mother asked the local resident for help. After that, Jin ran away from his house. Meanwhile, he was assisted by residents who rushed to the hospital. However, due to serious injuries, the victim's life was not safe. The incident was confirmed by the Forkat St. John Police Chief, Kaifi Janfitter Navitufulu. That's true, said Janfitter. When confirmed, Saturday, June 5, 2001, the police who received the report of the incidents immediately went to the scene. From Jamar, the police conduct a crime scan and examine a number of witnesses. Then, the Forkat St. John Police Criminal Investigation Unit moved to pursue the perpetrator. Also, at around 5 o'clock in the afternoon, the DN perpetrator was arrested by the police. The perpetrator were immediately taken to the police at the court of Forkat St. John to undergo in investigation and legal process. we have scored in and we are still doing the investigation, said Jan Vitter. That's all the news for today. I'm Mutia Amelia. Thank you for watching and have a great day.